the five Pengus things in football.
What do you reckon?
Pengus things in football, what do you mean by that? I see the money boy now, I'm bugging, come true with your crew, we can get to something and roll with me.
And blow some weed, ayo T, bring the keys. Yo, welcome back to the Poet of Vooz channel. We're here with Peng Ting Like Madison.
Peng Ting called Madison, my man.
How many times have you heard that?
Ah, so many times, bro.
Yeah, it's not gonna stop.
It's good at the start, but.
Are you bored? Are you bored?
Yeah, song's a bit old as well now, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no rules. It's a classic. No, no, no. You yeah, see things, certain things. I'm like, Zidane, classic. Do you know what I mean?
But you know,
anytime, oh,
huh? But you know when you're just watch, you know when you go like play FIFA or something?
Oh, yeah,
whenever you get the ball, in my head, Peng Ting Like Madison.
It's just. Bro.
Yeah, okay, we can let it live on a bit, all right?
Yeah, one season.
Shout out, no. Bro, how you been? Obviously, off-season, so it's start again, it's starting again. Yeah, we've been doing like in the off-season, asked by Ultra Fresh Willy.
Yeah, Yeah, I had a little break. We had the under-21 Euros. Yeah. So obviously I had a longer season than the rest, so I got a bit of an extended break when the lads came back in. Just under 3 weeks, so it wasn't long, but got myself off to the States, had a couple of holidays, a bit of downtime, went to LA.
My brother, LA.
Recharged the batteries, you know, and then back raring to go now, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's no rules, I asked the wrong question, but actually he asked, what's your favorite thing to do in leisure time when you're chilling?
Ooh, my leisure time. Do you know what? I like to go into the town and have a nice coffee.
Are you serious?
What's your order?
Depends what coffee shop I'm at.
Pretting.
Vanilla latte, something like that.
Do you go for alternative milks, or are you still on the milk thing?
Straight cow's milk.
Straight normal milk, yeah. We have a little coffee club crew at Leicester.
Who's part of the coffee club?
Ben Chilwell, me.
Chilwell's a baller.
Yeah, he's so good. Andy King, Harry Maguire was part of it.
Aye.
But yeah, he's a bit further north now. And Johnny Evans makes the odd appearance, but he's
Johnny Evans looks like
cultured club, innit?
Very cultured. But you should go for a little almond though.
Yeah, a little almond. Andy King likes the almond milk.
Yeah, because Jamie said to me, imagine giving breast milk from a woman to a cow.
True, no one
looks at that. That's mad. Yeah. And when I thought about I'm drinking the milk that's meant to be for a baby cow myself, I just jumped on the almond.
But you know what?
Never look back.
Don't fix it if it's not broken, do you know what I mean? I enjoy my vanilla latte.
I respect that.
And we're not cows, I guess, yeah. I mean,
yeah.
We can go into that and digress into those topics. Next question from Sinos Man is, how good is Hamza Chowdhury?
Very good. Good question. In training today, actually, he was on one today because he's a tough tackling midfielder.
Yeah.
Obviously, the Premier League starts at the weekend, so he's more than ready, but I'll tell you that. If you watch training today, he was going around smashing people.
Which is
a game.
Do you know what the killer is? You say that, you said you was doing the under-21s. That's something I love. Yeah. I love younger players. I don't know why, they're just hungrier. They want it. And I watched your team a lot, the under-21s, the England game. I was so upset the first game, the way you lost to France.
Yeah.
Broke my heart. Mm. Broke my heart. You played so well. But I remember one tackle from Chowdhury. And I remember saying to him, I tried to make excuses for him. And then Vooz was like, Paul, you haven't. So he's just gone straight back. How is he able, and how are you not able to just go from like that situation straight back in the Premier League and carry on a bit like?
Well, the break probably helped him because obviously he got sent off in the France game.
Yeah.
And we were 1-0 up at the time.
That was mad.
And we went on to lose 2-1. We come in the change room after and he's actually crying.
Apologising
to the lads because we put so much work into that. So when the season finished and all the lads were off on holiday and stuff like that, we went straight into training with England. So we had a few weeks camp before the Euros even started. We're together as a group for 4 weeks before the tournament even starts. You know what I mean, every day. So we were so focused, so ready for that tournament. We wanted to do so well, and obviously he felt like he let us down. It wasn't that he had to make a elastic tackle, but that's just what it meant to him. And that's the type of guy he is. He puts it all out there. He puts it all on the line, and he mistimes a tackle. But if it's like 1 millisecond earlier, he makes a clean tackle with the ball, and everyone says, like, save the goal.
Yeah. Yeah. But, that must make your job easier though, because
especially when I'm in there.
Techie players, the techie ones, so the folders,
they're so. Last year, when you got Hamza in there, me and Youri Tielemans playing a bit more advanced, when you got Hamza behind you, mopping stuff up, him and Ndidi, two of the best ball winners in the league there.
Leicester City are lit.
Young
player, like 21? Do you know, I was going on loan to Leicester City as a fan for 6 months. I was all planning it. Yeah, I went to go on loan to Leicester and then renew it potentially in January. Because if players can go on loan, fans can go on loan.
I agree.
But we had a good transfer window, so I wouldn't. Why not?
What's your current club?
My current club is Arsenal. You understand the heart.
A tattoo.
A lot. I've got a tattoo. Got Thierry Henry here. Yeah. I've got Ian Wright, I've got friends now. Yeah, like, I'm asked. But Leicester City, I've got so much good players.
Sauce.
There's so much sauce and a good story.
What sauce would Leicester be if you could pick a sauce? Because you guys have sauce.
Sauce, a lot.
What sauce would we be? We'd be a hot sauce, you know what I mean? Because we're fiery at the minute. A little chili sauce.
Like a chili sauce, yeah. I
like chili playing left back as well, so no pun intended. But
chili.
So then you got Buzz. Yeah, that's why you got the watch. Peng I got you. I was saying, I'm Peng Tian Kwon Madison.
Man, all right. Next question. Well, we were speaking about obviously how good Hamza Chowdhury is. The next one from Loz Newman is, what's it like playing with Youri Tielemans? Just another baller.
I mentioned him. Yeah, he's top draw, yeah. You just need to watch him for 15 minutes and you know he's a top player. Mm. There's a reason he plays for Belgium and starts for Belgium, you know what I mean? So yeah. When he's playing with Hazard and De Bruyne and them, man, yeah, he does his stuff. So you watch him in training every day, he's just quality. Like, he oozes class, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He's a top player and he's a top professional as well.
Serious?
He's the nicest guy you'll ever meet, honestly. Most polite, nice, down-to-earth guy ever. And we got on off the pitch as well, so he's a good friend of mine now. And I can't speak highly enough of him. Yeah,
question is though, is he going Coffee Club? Because I want to go Coffee Club.
I'm trying to join Coffee Club.
I remember Casper said we should go down to training because it's so Leicester is amazing.
Yeah,
amazing.
Did it?
Yeah, Casper's a legend. Like, lovely guy. He's not in Coffee Club. He's got a wife and a kid.
The
second one on the way, I think, as well. So
I'm with him.
He's
not
on
with
daddy.
The wife.
He's on daddy duties.
Do you guys listen to podcasts as well?
Not really.
Not a podcast guy.
No, I wouldn't say no to it. Like, some of the lads do, but I haven't.
Well, this one here, though, from Dan14 Slade. Who do I choose from, all right? Fantasy, because fantasy is obviously a big part of the Prem starting.
That's it.
Out of you, 7 million, Tielemans, 6.5, Perez, 6.5, or Gray, 5.5.
Forgot you signed Perez.
That's tough.
I might go back on loan.
So please.
I'm thinking about
it. Let Danny know, who does he choose? Because you're obviously a bit pricey. Sometimes you've got to sacrifice.
Yeah.
Who would you go for if you're there by the computer screen?
Oh. What type of guy would I be if I didn't back myself?
That's what my bro, that's it! That's it! You
7
have to
million.
Back yourself, man.
I think, you know, I'll back myself for that. Hopefully I can get some points on the board for Dan.
And see that rising as well.
Yeah, it rises, doesn't it?
It rises.
But if I was to take myself out of the equation, Jose Perez is a good bet. He's a top finisher from what I've seen so far.
He's gone Leicester.
He's gone Leicester, bro, from Newcastle. Chairman came out and said it's the biggest mistake he's made. Think about this Leicester side for 1 second. I might go alone. I'm thinking about it. Alone!
I know this is a fumer job. But, yo, I might have to get
I might have to go on loan, get the Leicester kit, bro. I'm just thinking about it. Their team. Look at the midfield. I played with them. I bought all the players that they've got on FIFA.
And also, I'm going to be honest with you. I would support Liverpool. I do transfer from clubs here and there, right? But what you lot, I reckon we're going to beat them. If company never put that top bins.
Oh, my lord.
I think you lot nearly won Liverpool the league.
I know. We didn't even need to win, did we? We just needed a draw for you.
Just draw.
Was there a bit of that like chat from outside? People like, you can win Liverpool the league.
There was so much. I think obviously, I can't remember who Liverpool played. I think it was maybe Wolves on the last day. But people were saying Leicester's are on the up, and you can't ignore the world. I mean, you hear people say it to you, and we knew going into that game we could have a big say in the title race. And do you know what? The first half we played really well. Like, we're playing out from the back.
Pep
came out and said obviously he'd never seen a team. Like, I spoke to Phil Foden at the Euros. He said there's no team that came to the Etihad and played out like the way we did. So, when company spanks in the top corner, you know it's meant to be.
It's funny you say Liverpool though, because they're playing your former side tomorrow. And that's the first time I watched. I remember the last season you were at Norwich, and I thought this player is just so good. Like, why don't people watch Championship and other league? There's so many good players. I hate the whole notion that you have to play for a big club to be a good player. There's so many good young players, even like McGinn at Aston Villa. I mean, there's a load of good players, but you was one at Norwich, obviously.
Yeah.
How are you going to approach that game against Norwich when you go to Carrow Road? Have you ever had to do that before, like play against your former club? Is this going to be the first time?
Yeah, I mean, it's
the first time playing against a former club. That would be different, that would be weird. Yeah, I went back to Carrow Road and played there for England under 21s because we had a game there. I got a brilliant reception.
Of course.
I had such a good relationship with the Norwich fans. I felt like when I left Norwich, it was the fan. Normally when you see people leaving, and obviously it's the transfer deadline day today, you see that when there's talk of someone leaving, the fans are a bit like, what? But when there was talk about me leaving Norwich for Leicester, it was almost like the fan base were happy for me to go and to the next level. And I didn't get any hate, didn't get anything. Like, normally you expect a little percentage of the fans to be like, oh, he left, whatever, blah, blah. But I've got none of that, nothing but love. So and had a great time there. I'd still speak to the owner, Delia. Still speak to the manager, the sporting director, and
Delia, legend.
Legend in football.
What did she say again when she
went on the Where are you? I said, you sold him.
But brilliant club. Can't speak highly enough of it, so I can't wait to go back.
That's amazing, man.
So, wicked, wicked. Pablo Ragunde says, who drinks more water, you or drink water?
Ooh.
I mean, it's a very important question.
That's a very important question.
That's probably the biggest one that we've asked today.
I'm not sure how much water drink.
Does water. He drink that? How much drink water could drink water drink if drink water could only drink water?
A lot.
I like that.
I can't believe that.
The exclusive has been broken. A lot.
And you know what? You're taking a look at one thing I can say about the Premier League. It seems to just be attracting the best young players in the world and, you know, best players in the world in general. Where did Leicester fit in this situation now? Because your midfield is incredible. You can't deny it. Your midfield's absolutely incredible. Something's happening over there.
Yeah.
Top six, that must be a target for you, man.
Yeah, it's got to be a target. And you speak about the midfield, but we've got one of the most prolific goal scorers in Jamie Vardy. Forget about the midfield and the young lads. He's
a rude boy.
You've got to love Jamie Vardy.
I love Jamie Vardy.
People, he weren't talked about enough last year. He ended up scoring 19 league goals in the Premier League.
The way
no
he
one
ended,
even mentioned him last year.
Is really. That the Brendan Rodgers effect? Because he came in and I wanted him at Arsenal.
Yeah.
And I just saw the way you lot played against us and it broke my heart, bro. Like, but, broke it.
With the team that we've got, we know we've got quality. We've got a top manager in Brendan Rodgers because he is top drawer. And we've got to be aiming for the top six. I'd be naive to sit here and tell you different. So.
I might move. I'm sorry, Arsenal. I love you, but you know, this is mad.
Yeah, no, you lot killed it. I mean, obviously, Leicester won the league. And that was the magical, magical season.
Beautiful.
How did you find out watching as a spectator? Obviously, you weren't there yet.
Yeah.
How was that for you? Because I remember like just watching every game, going on the streams and every... How mad is football? Like for you, like as
it should never have happened, right?
Right, yeah.
But I was almost, for that second half, so obviously Leicester got off to a fly, didn't they?
Yeah.
And I remember thinking, everyone was thinking, they're gonna fall off, whatever. They might nick a Europa League spot or something. But they just kept going, didn't they? And I think for that second half of the season, I became a Leicester fan. Just because I was a football fan. I think everyone did, right?
Yeah, everyone did.
And everyone just wanted them to do it. And obviously Jamie Vardy scored 11 games in a row and set the record, beat Ruud van Nistelrooy's record of 10 games in a row. You know how hard it is to score 11 Premier League games in a row?
Bro, do you know how hard it is to score point blank?
Yeah.
I play centre-back, mate. I've never scored, ever. But
they should never have won the league, and it was a fantastic story. Yeah. And yeah, that was all because of Kumbucha as well, God rest his soul.
Well, it seems like Leicester are still up there, man. You're a great, great club. What's the atmosphere like at the club itself since you've come there? It seems like a real family.
Yeah, it's such a family club. And obviously, with the tragic passing of our owner in the helicopter crash, we want everything that he's installed into us and his legacy, we want that to live on. And Kuntop's doing a fantastic job of running the club at the minute, and hopefully we can keep that going.
Danny Alcohol says, hairstyling tips because damn.
Bro, look at that. Let them know, my brother.
You know what, I've actually,
that is Love Island competition for me.
I had a nap in the car on the way as well, so it's probably not looking the best, but I'll just whack a bit of product and hairspray now and go out and hope it looks all right.
Growing up, and who was your rider in football? Because you're very technically gifted. Where you play in that number 10 role, there are so many great players you must have watched growing up. Who was a player that you said, you know what, I can model my game off them?
Well, it's two different answers for that question, because the guy I actually grew up idolising, I'm nothing like him, Cristiano Ronaldo.
Serious?
When I was obviously coming through school, he was the main attraction of Premier League football, playing for Manchester United. And I used to just love him. I used to watch his free kicks, I used to watch him, his tricks on YouTube and like IT lessons, you know what I mean, when I was younger. But then if I look at my position, players like David Silva, who's been at City 10 years, he's one of the greatest creators the Premier League's seen. Felipe Coutinho, when he was at Liverpool, he was a little magician, wasn't he? All them sorts of players. They've got sauce, Flairy number 10s, playmakers,
Look out for them. Midfield. I like them players.
I mean, I think there's only one way I really want to end this, right? We started with painting like Madison.
Yeah.
I think we end it with that as well. The five Pengest things in football.
What do you reckon?
Pengest things in football? What do you mean by that?
Like
amazing.
The best looking football players. Because for me, it would be Van Dijk, Van Dijk, Van Dijk, Van Dijk, and Van Dijk. So I don't know. I mean, for you,
Madison.
We're
Madison,
opening. Madison, do you know what I mean?
Madison, yeah, yeah.
What do you reckon? Like, the best looking lads. But the Pengest things, as they would say in. There's notes to say.
Notes, yeah.
Do you know what? There's a good friend of mine, Jordan Turnbull. He's a centre half. You might not know him, for Northampton. Got the best beard I've ever seen in football.
I'm going Goes to the same right bar.
The photo will pop up. You can let us know in the comments under what you reckon.
He's got the strongest beard in football. Let me tell you that. We go to the same barber, and he's sometimes after me. So I go in there, I get the barber to shape up my beard. I'm like, you know what? Yeah, I'm looking alright. And he comes in, and I'm just like,
Santa Claus.
Really? Like, just let me have my moment for 5 minutes. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But and he's a top guy as well.
Is that one? But could you give us a couple more? Like in the Prem, perhaps. I'm trying to get this one out. This is my favourite question.
Chile, my best mate, he's a good looking geezer. Ben Chilwell. Slick back hair.
Very, he seems like very well dressed, very well
groomed. Yeah, clean guy.
Ben Chilwell. Leicester, you know.
Graziano Pella, who used to play for Southampton. He was a bit of a threat, I'm sure.
He said, I'm going to make some money and I'm out.
Valentine's Day, you see him on the street. Your missus might look.
If that was my missus' friend, I would accept the feat.
Yeah.
If my girl looked, I'd be like, do you know what? Fair enough.
You have to hold your hands up.
You can have a look.
The man is.
He's a good looking geezer.
It's happened to me in real life, but enough about me, guys.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Okay. That's nice. Bro, appreciate that. Thank you very much.
I appreciate it, Madison. Thank you so much. A couple minutes of Madison. Booch.
I think that was longer than 10 as well. I think we dragged it out. So, agents, everyone behind the camera.
I'm sorry.
Thank you. It wasn't 10. But, James, appreciate the interview.
I'm leaving this interview, and I've got 24 hours to make my decision.
All right.
Am I going to Leicester City on loan for 6 months? It just sounds crazy.
It's
over
appealing.
There. It's appealing.
Like, comment.
Let me know. Let me know.
I'll let you know.
Like, comment, subscribe, and also we end it with have a nice.
Have a nice.
A G.